Hello everyone, in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can use a Kaggle dataset inside Vertex AI to train a model and evaluate the model once the model is trained and finally deploy the model to an endpoint to predict the values, eventually test the model. So without any further delay, let's see that in action. So here I am inside my Google Cloud console. So the first thing that I have downloaded a dataset from Kaggle, and I'm going to use the dataset to train my model. The dataset which I have downloaded is basically a loan predictor dataset. What I have done is that I have created one cloud storage, which you can also do by going into the cloud storage overview and then create the bucket. And inside the bucket, you can upload the CSV file or your dataset which you have downloaded from Kaggle. So in my case, this is the bucket, and inside the bucket, this is the CSV file or the dataset which I've downloaded from Kaggle. This step is very important because once you uploaded the dataset, it will give you a GSUtil URI, which we'll be using to create my Vertex AI dataset. So once this is done, let me go to my Google Cloud in a separate tab, and now I'll go to the Vertex AI and go to dashboard. So here I am inside my Google Vertex AI dashboard. So if this is the first time that you are clicking on the Vertex AI, it might be needed that you need to enable the API. So go and click enable the API, Vertex AI API. One thing that you need to keep in mind, whatever you'll do inside Vertex AI, it's not free. It will consume your free usage or it will charge you. So make it very clear that it's not free and you will be charged for your activity inside the Vertex AI. Okay, with that, here what I'll do is basically, or what I have done is basically, I have created a dataset. So inside Vertex AI, you will come and click on here. This is a place where you'll create the dataset. I've already created my dataset, but let me show you how you can create your own dataset. So you need to click on create. And then these are the four different types of dataset that is Vertex AI can support: image, tabular, text, and video. Since my data source is CSV, so I'm going to select tabular. And then based on that, what is going to be my model objective? Is it going to be a regression problem I'm going to solve or a forecasting? So for here, I'm going to select regression and then click on create. And here we have three options. Either you can upload your dataset from your computer or upload your dataset from a cloud storage or from a table or a view inside query. So in this case, I am going to select the second option, which is basically the CSV file from the storage. Here, you need to give the path, the GSUtil URI. Either you can copy this path or you can do click on browse here and it will show you all the buckets that you have. And inside the bucket, you can select the data source and click on select and then click on continue. Once you click on continue, this is a page which will come up. So this is basically what is happening here. We have created the data set. So let me go back and show you the data set which I have already created. So let me delete this one now. So this is the data set which I've already created. So if you click on here, this is the source file from where the data set was created. So once your data source is created, one very important thing is that you should click on the generate statistics. What it will tell you, how many columns are there inside the data set, how many rows are there, what are the missing values, and how many distinct values against each of the column and the column names. Everything will come once you click on the statistics button. But you need to keep in mind, it's not instant. It will take probably a couple of minutes to create, generate the statistics. Okay. Once this is done, our dataset is ready. So once your dataset is ready, you need to use this dataset to train the model. So to do that, you need to click on train the model, train a new model. So click on this button and then select other. Here you will select what is objective. Objective is classification, auto ML, click on continue. This is the name. What is your target column? Target column is a column which you want your model to predict based on the other values inside the dataset. So for example here, from all the fields, I think the loan status is what I want to be my target column because I want to make sure my model will predict whether the loan will be approved or rejected, which is basically the loan status column. Click on continue. This is important. If you click on here, it will show you all the columns that is present inside the dataset. Now, if you think some of the columns are not relevant in making the prediction, you can delete them from here. So if I go by all the column names, loan ID, it has no relevance whether my loan will be approved or rejected. So I can go ahead and click on this minus sign, which will exclude this column from the training. Similar way, you can exclude other columns also. But for the timing, let's continue. Let's exclude only the loan ID and click on continue. This is a place where I will give one, and once means estimated completion time is 1 hour. So it will train the model for 1 hour at least. Now, this is very important because how many hours you are going to allocate to train your model, that depends on the pricing. So there is a pricing guide which you should always follow to get the latest information. What will be the cost to train my model? So I'm not going to train my model because my model has already been trained. So I'm going to cancel here. But once you train your model, this is how it will look like. It will come here. But another way to go is basically you click here and then you come here, click on training. It will show you this model was trained and the duration was 2 hours and 18 seconds it was taken to train the model. So once you click on that, once the model is trained, is very important to understand once the model is trained and the model is ready, every model will be registered under this model registry. So if you click here, if you click on the Vertex API, and there is an option called model registry. So in the model under model registry, you will find the trained model. So let me open my trained model. First thing is like here is a trained model and here is evaluate. So first, before I deploy this model, I need to understand, or you need to understand, you know, how my model is behaving. So you need to evaluate your model. So let's click on that. There are three metrics that you can get from the evolution. So one is based on the confidence threshold. You will get the precision recall curve, ROC curve, and the precision recall by threshold. So these are the important information which will help you to decide whether my model is good enough to be deployed. Another one is a confusion matrix. This is a very important information. And I have a dedicated video on this topic. So if you haven't seen that video, I'll put the link in the description as well as on the top right corner. Please go and check that out because this is something that you should know if you're dealing with machine learning and data science. And another one is a feature importance. It's basically telling which feature is having the maximum importance to predict the outcome. So if I see here from this graph, it looks like the CIBIL score is having the maximum importance, which is 88.65% to decide whether my loan will be approved or rejected. Yep. So if you are good with that, then is the time to deploy this model and to make the model available for further prediction. So if that is true, then you click on here, deploy. And you click on deploy to endpoint. I've already have my module deployed, but I'm going to show you how you can do that. So once you come here, there will be nothing here. So you need to click on deploy to endpoint. You need to give the endpoint name. Let's say I'm giving test. You click on continue. You don't need to change anything here. Just keep it like feature attribution and then click on continue. Here, everything looks good to me. Click on continue. I think I missed some information here. What is the model settings? Let's go back to the model settings. Yep, this option is very important because this will decide how much you'll be charged for your model, for the deployment of your model. So I normally, for my practice, I normally go with the E2. They are having the cheapest price associated with that. So I go with the E2 standard 4. You can also do the same thing, then click on continue. Model objectives, this model monitoring is good. Model objective is basically what is my training data. Training data location is basically here. That's my training data location and the target column. Target column is basically which column? Target column is the loan status, I believe, which I can get again from the Vertex AI and the datasets. Loan status is my target column. So I can copy that and put it here. And then click on deploy. So I'm not going to deploy this model because I have already deployed it. I'm just want to show you how you can do that. Okay, so once you deploy a model, this is how it will look like. You can click on that. And it's telling this is what my model is doing. This is what my model is you know, how many requests came and everything, it will show you. But how to test the model? So once you come here, this is endpoint. Once you come here, not here, let me go and click on the model registry. From here, I'll go here and then click on deploy and test. Okay, so this is what my model deployment is already being deployed. As you can see, it's active. Now these are all the parameters. So now here I can play. If I say, let's say number of dependents is 5 and education is not graduated, self-employed, say no. Annual income, let's say 150. And then I can click on predict and it will predict and it will say, okay, my loan will be approved. Similar way, I can say, yeah, this time the data tells that the candidate is self-employed, and then click on predict and it will tell you, okay, this time also it will be approved. And this is a confidence score. This is a baseline prediction value. So if you see here, they're very close. And if you click on here, you will find all this information, how many requests came. So I can see there's 2 requests came. And that's all. And that's how you basically use the data set to train a model, evaluate the model performance, and if you are good, you can deploy the model to predict the values. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit the like icon. Please subscribe to my channel so that in future, when I'll be publishing more videos like this, you will be the first person to be notified. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.